Alrighty then, folks, we have finished the last interlude we have, probably for this entire game, so now we must go and start on Stardust Memory. So you might notice the background music's quite a bit lower. It's because I don't want to get copyright again. That'd be interesting. Yeah. Let's start with that afterglow of Zeon. This is going to be interesting. If there's a ton of ads on this video, you know exactly why. But hey, Aboku got destroyed. Who would have guessed? Wouldn't it have been a continuation of the previous war? Unless, you know, you're recognizing the laws as a separate faction. They really like using drawing back the curtain or like Rikishi. It's like a phase in war. I usually say it's something else, but they use that like a lot in Gearing's Greed. It's kind of annoying, actually. It's like, yeah, you know, we're playing a game. We need to be reminded of this constantly. It's that afterglow. A long siege voyage of like a day. But we're flying with flying with Synapse and the Albion to Torrington. Which I'm thinking of replacing the white base with the Albion after this is over. I thought about doing it with the Grey Phantom, but the Albion actually has some good attacks versus the Grey Phantom, which really doesn't. But that means we're gonna have to unlock the Albion the hard way, which should be interesting. If this is anything like the first episode of Spirits, then like, this first battle's gonna be really annoying. Oh, hey, look, Azamul. We have all of those. That's Azamul and a Domfumpf. Or a Tropin. Now we're magically in Torrington. Synapis. Notice how Synapis and then Synapse, how it's spelled, they're different. I don't know why you guys are gonna leave a nuke in the gun, but you are. It's one thing I never got about this, they left a nuke in the gun. I'm curious to see whether it is following Liberation or if it's following the original. I'm assuming the original, but it might be Liberation. I'm pretty sure this is falling in normal because they didn't really have this interaction when, like, in Liberation. I think in the very beginning they were studying Azaku for some reason. Because they just kind of left a mostly intact Zaku over near the base. That crescendo in the back when he got shot down was great. Aw, no Gundam tours. Well, no, he doesn't, but he gets some really good machines that kind of compensate for that. Oh, I should have checked if there's quests. Besides, you know, get Gage a mobile suit that Ko is using, or something like that. Oh well, we'll check when the battle actually starts. Should be soon. But just saying, if he had like a lieutenant commander's uniform, wouldn't it be harder for him? Because like he would have to go talk to the base commander first. He wouldn't just be able to waltz in. Whereas a lieutenant, no one really gives a shit, because you're just a lieutenant. Yeah, she's only into Zeon pilots. Someone claiming to be a Zeon. For the rebirth of Zeon. No, they said John. They're talking about the rebirth of John. Luckily, they have some Zacks. I'm assuming it's a Chase Gato kind of thing. No, not my Gundams. This is Synapis. Alright, we gotta destroy Gato in 4 turns. Which is gonna be interesting since it's just Ko. First, wrong list. Stardust, yeah. Max out Ko, yeah. Complete the thing. Complete this and we unlock Keith. Add LB into the production list, I figured. Yeah. We have to defeat Gato within 4 turns. Alright. Do we have the beam rifle? We do. So yeah, he defended, so he only takes 2/3 damage. But here's the thing, he's gonna heal about 1,000, so if we do two hits to him and then we melee him twice, we'll kill him. Assuming he just moves away and doesn't attack us. Oh, no, he's actually defending. I figured he would attack back. Oh, well. Yeah, so we need to shoot him twice more. I'm actually gonna dodge, because screw that. Have fun. I honestly don't care if you destroy the Albion. Oh, shit, we need to beam rifle literally every single time. Never mind. We killed him. I was figuring we'd have to restart that. Alright then. But hey, we got the challenge. A GM powered, a captured Zaku 2. And GM Kai, or GMC, whatever they call it in this one. I just noticed Keith is in an Ace uniform. Keith is an Ace? I wouldn't have expected that. Because he's not in a test pilot uniform, he's in the white and red one. Well, no, actually, if you succeed in this one, you're gonna have to invade the Earth Federation from the ground. But then using nukes doesn't really give you any experience, so we're gonna just throw you in a bunch of, like, Gundams or something. Basically, whatever you have on hand. Probably Gerber Tetris, actually. Yeah, so with this stage, like, as you move forward, more people appear. It just gets ridiculous after a while. It's just like, oh hey, more Doms, who would have guessed. Also knows that guy's name is Dick. The enemy, they're coming. Oh, hey, it's a late class Komusai. Well, they need a mass driver to do that. So, like, it's basically a waste of a Komusai. Yeah, maybe this one isn't as bad as it used to be, which would be nice. Who knows? Yeah, we got what appears to be 9 Dom 2s and a Komisai. It's probably going to be like have Ko destroy the Komisai in like 10 turns or something like that. Yeah. Ko just has to destroy the Komisai. Awesome. So what we're going to do is we're going to move forward. We're going to missile barrage one of these guys because they can't hit us back. We're going to go grab out Sayla real quick. We're going to shoot this guy. So I want Ko to move forward and kill him so he gets an extra movement. Yeah, fuck. Yeah, okay, that's the animation. Yep, okay, this one's getting copyrighted. God damn it. Oh well. It is what it is. Yeah, he missed, and it's still playing the goddamn song. Alright. Come on, I get it. Let's see. Hey, Agar, I know you don't play the song, so let's look at your new attack. I wasn't expecting that to one-hit kill him, but it did. So yeah, if there's ads all over this video, my apologies, but there's nothing I can do about it. I had to copyright that song. Probably just that one specifically, too. I know some of the Zeta songs from Gundam vs. Double Zeta have been claimed. So, yeah, that one might also be very quiet. I think Double Zeta might be good, but I could be wrong. Yeah, and then we're going to Scissor Claw him with the Belanook Shinanaham. So I'm curious. Is there anyone else we want to kill a thing with? You know, Ko, I guess? Let's use the long barrel missile launcher for the lulls. Yeah, it's about what I expected with the defensor. This is the backpack to the Super Gundam, which is why you can only get it through the Super Gundam. You basically mount it on the Mark II and it becomes like super awesome, except for, you know, very slow. So, do we even want to use Zeon this time? We don't really need to. Yeah, we don't need to. Let's see, we've used those before. I kind of want to see what the heavy stick is. We can beam rifle with her, I guess, real quick. Or the melee stick, not heavy stick. See if it's anything different. Yeah, not particularly. So yeah, we'll melee stick with the Geezy, and then I guess we'll send forward the rebuilt Kshatriya. Oh, it's quite literally just a stick. I like how you sound badass with a dude hitting somebody else with a stick. But yeah, that almost leveled him up, so I think we might go for another kill with him if we can. Because then we can just get the other one, like, immediately. I'm assuming this is gonna one-shot, though. Yeah, see why I thought that was a bard each? It looks like it. Yeah, I don't care that you can, you know, shoot back at us and fail. It's not particularly interesting. So yeah, we'll leave that one alive, let him get the kill, and then we'll have her counterattack these other guys. Then yeah, we'll move Ko up and have him take out this thing. Wow. Got really close to killing him. Then beam Gatling, and then we'll funnel missile somebody else. Or we'll funnel missile him next turn or something. I remember this mission being a lot harder in spirits. Then I wasn't, like, this high level in spirits. Alright, so Ko, have you move here? You can't shoot him. Alright, never mind. We're gonna have you go after this one. Go here. Yeah, you can't hit him. You'll hit him next turn. View here. Have her move to up here. Psychomew missiles. Who doesn't like funnels guided by magic? Space magic in particular. Yeah, we're gonna move her up. Have her hit that one, but not kill it, hopefully. Yeah, awesome. Yeah, we could hit it one more time with that and still get away with it. We'll move these guys back in. So I'm expecting some reinforcements at the top after this. After this is over, move everyone back to get ready for them. Oops. Yeah, need to upgrade that one too. It's cool if the Tropin decides to shoot at the ship instead. Like, I really don't care. He won't be able to do enough damage to even, like, moderately affect us. No, I don't want to risk it. So I say we could always just glance him and then kill him immediately. No, don't want to risk it. It should level up the Geezy, which means we won't have to use the Geezy again. I guess we could use the Yazon one if you guys want to, but the only difference is it's pink. Or no, we have to get to level 3, shit. Alright, never mind. We can get the Ogo if we wanted, though. Haven't unlocked that one. I was getting the Balanook Shinanaham and that one mixed up. Yeah, so close. Oh well. Yeah. If you guys are wondering why I care about the copyright claim, if I get 2 copyright claims, I can't post videos longer than 15 minutes for 6 months. Which means I'm not posting videos for 6 months. Which is why I care. I don't mind not doing it. I've got a lot more free time on my hands, but it'll kind of kill the fact that this is my hobby.
The Nightmare of Solomon.
They're quoting Wilberforce, aren't they? The sword that cuts the shackles was William Wilberforce. I know that one. Really? Only 2 guys? Oh well. Like, yeah, there's more talking in, like, this part than there was in the whole beginning of the campaign. Oh, hey, they actually got more reinforcements, too. Awesome. Means I don't have to go out of my way to try to capture them. Or, to try to level the Geezy up. Oh, hey, and Fritz Helms. Don't worry, we'll kill him next turn. Yeah, so I think we'll have the Balanook Shinanaham go kill one of them. We'll have the Geezy go kill that one, and then we'll have somebody else go kill the commander, and then we'll rank them all up. And hell, we could go have Amon go kill the commander, for that matter. But yeah, so we'll have the Geezy. Oh no, we should have Rumble Rawl do it. Hopefully this is enough damage. Yeah. And rank up? Yeah, awesome. Got him to level 4, in fact. Yeah, they're worth so much EXP, it's ridiculous. That wasn't even the commander, too, which is worth a little bit more. Yeah, so now we can go get the other Geezy. Oh, it's a red in this one. Yeah, Yazons. Basically, it's the same thing. Maybe we'll get that and train it up to an Ogo or something, I don't know. Who do we want to get a kill? You need to get to level 3, so that's not going to happen. You need to get to level 3 as well. And then you need to get to level 3. Gonna send you back, though, because you need energy. And send you all the way forward. Yeah, you know what? Mm-hmm. I can get the Palace Athene. So what we're going to do with you is you are going to go beam gun this guy. Then we will have... let's have Mallet do it, because why not? We need that Sleeves Dovin Wolf, even though it's going to be the exact same thing as the current Dovin Wolf. Then we can have either Marion or Rumble Rawl go out and kill it. Yeah, you know what? Send Rumble Rawl out to here. And we'll have them both go together and kill those other two Tropins. Hopefully that'll get him to level 3. Oh. Alright then, I didn't know that was gonna happen. It's basically a one-shot with the funnels, so... Or almost a one-shot with the funnels. As soon as we get the tension up, it should be a one-shot. Are the funnels any different? I doubt it, but, you know, we can always try. Yeah, no, it's the same thing. Hey, the Gion should level up from this, which should be nice. Halfway there. Then, yeah, we just need 2 more kills with you to get to that level, and then we need, you know, 2 more kills with you to get the just 1 level higher. Then we'll kill that other one in the counterattack, and then, you know, everyone should be happy. Well, you'll get close. He won't level up, but he'll get close. So I'll just go kill, like, a Saberfish or something later. Then we'll have the Norn go kill that one. Oh, and the anti-air dust, the asshole. Do we have anything anti-large? Well, let's use the Beam Magnum because I'm sure it'll kill. And then we'll use the Beam Revolver somewhere else. What do you say, Karis? No, that's not Karis. The other one's Karis. I forget his name. Bob? The one who ends up surviving the war is Karis. He brings Nina to safety. I weirdly saw that on a trivia thing about Stardust Memory, like a long ass time ago. I don't know why they had one, they just did. Yeah, let's move you up to here. That's cool. Wonder, if you go to new type mode, will you go to... Or if you go high tension, will you go new type? Mm-hmm. Close are you to high tension anyway? Two kills. One more kill and we'll find out if we can get NTD with an old type. Which would be interesting if we can. Yep. Not defensive support, I don't care about that. Alright, so melee. I'm assuming it's gonna be like slash through and fly off thing. Mm-hmm. Nope. That kind of sucks, but oh well. Maybe we'll give the unicorn to Amuro. Or the banshee to Amuro. I don't know. If Amuro, if we had either Zeta Amuro or Amuro had more command than, you know, a paper bag, we'd just have him as commander. But having over 200 commands, so nice. Yeah, we'll just train them later. It's fine. Haman versus Gato, go. I'm just waiting for, you know, Gato to try to nuke us, because, you know, he only has one nuke. I think that would be funny. Oh, poo. Never mind, spear fight. Oh. Wow, is the GPO2 the only unit to have Vulcans in this game? I honestly forgot that was a thing. Wow, is it really the only thing to have Vulcans? Yay, the Kshatriya leveled up. Alright, and we'll just murder this guy real quick. Some reason we can't new type missile him because he's underwater, I guess? That kind of sucks. Okay, we can actually shoot at him. Alright. Could have Dalaz, or, Rumble Rawl kill him. I thought I said Dalaz. Eh. I guess we could have Dalaz pilot a thing. But haven't we already unlocked him? I think we already unlocked him through something random. Yay. But folks, that was that. Like the video if you liked it, dislike it if you didn't. We'll be back for some more tomorrow. Yeah. Got Ko because we have the GPO one for forever. We got Chuck, and then...